Hello everyone and welcome to this video training on sparkline charts. Now, what is a sparkline chart? It's a very much simplified form of a line chart where I will not have any kind of axis or anything, and it would simply show the way the data has been moving over a past. Sometimes we look at the daily share price movement. We are not much bothered about the share price in that, but I am more interested in what is the way it is moving. Is it in an upish trend or a downward trend, or is it more flat? So in that kind of a scenario, I would resort to the usage of sparkline chart. So coming to this data, I would like to apply the sparkline chart on the performance of the person in the last 10 matches. How many runs he has scored in the last 10 matches. Of course, it may not signify anything big, but at least it can show me whether he has been performing in a decent fashion, or is there a lot of volatility in his form, or has he performed much worser in the last few days or few matches. This entire kind of information can very well be obtained. So that is where I take the use of sparkline chart. So I'll try to create that sparkline chart in this zone. So that's where I'm earmarking this location for this. I'm highlighting with this color, making this this. And last 10 innings. Right, if required, I'll even make this bold. Now, in this location, I'll create that sparkline. Now, how do I create that sparkline chart? For that, let me create a query. My query is plot the last 10 performances of the selected player. Here in this case, I simply want the runs that he has scored in the last 10 matches. Now, how would I get that data? My run sheet actually contains them, but if I want it more dynamic, I may not be able to get these runs. So that's where I would like to depend on one more column. Again, something for the selected player itself. Row number for the selected player. If I take that, then I can very well try to find out how many runs he has scored in his last 10 matches. Because from there, I will use the formulas like large to get the last 10. Of course, there are multiple ways. If I use VBA, it can become even more simpler in this aspect, but yeah, I don't want to drive VBA at this point. So from that perspective, I would like to know which are the last 10 matches of this person. You may say I should sort the data or something. Then that's a manual intervention. The moment there is a manual intervention on the data, if some other player name is changed, I have to resort it on that name of the player, which will make it quite uncomfortable in the plotting of the charts. So what I simply go with is, I'll go with row number for the selected person. Row number of the selected person. So what we should do in this is slightly I increase, and even I can make it like right click, format cells, and I can do a wrap text so that my headings are fitted in this area. Now, what I should do is, wherever the player name is matching, just like the way we got the year, I suggest that if the player name is equal to, go into the dashboard, select the name of the player and put a dollar by pressing F4. If the player name is equal to this selected name of the player, comma, display the row corresponding to that person. So, I'll say row of, then you select this run sheet and select this location. So, it will write row of runs-b2, comma, leave it as blank. So, what it does is, wherever this player name is matching, it will point out to the row number of that selected player. Then, I'll have a mechanism to pull out those top 10 row numbers, which means they are the latest 10 matches for that person. And corresponding to that, I would try to pull out the runs for the person using the different formulas which we have discussed earlier also. So, this is one formula which I am applying. Alright, so once I drag this formula, I will get all the matches in which this player has played and the row number corresponding to that. With this as an input, I'll do the data setting. So, the data setting here, I'll put it as Sparkline charts, and I need the last 10. So, I'll put 1, 2 and then drag it up to 10. Right? And here what I'll do is, I'll use the large function to start with. Because that will give me the first largest and second largest kind of stuff. I'll use the large function. So, it asks me for an array and a key. For array, I go into the run sheet. And I select this O column, comma, I need the nth largest. So, here I need the first largest, which means I again select this data setting sheet, select this one and then close the bracket. So, what this means is 7,392nd row corresponds to the largest value corresponding to this person. Largest row number corresponding to this person. I don't need the row number. I actually require the runs corresponding to that row number. So, what I'll do is, I'll do an index on the top of this and go to this runs column, run sheet, point to the B column, which means in that B column, the system will pull out the 7,392nd row, which means the runs corresponding to that player. Oh, so B column is actually giving me the name of the person. So, to get the runs, I have to do it on the C column. So, what you can do is, instead of taking this B colon B, make it as C colon C. This will give that in the last match, this person has scored 5. And what you can very well do is, the moment you are dragging it, it shows that these are the 10 this person has scored in his last 10 matches. But yeah, this one is his last, the 10th last, and this one is the last. To plot a proper chart, I suggest instead of keeping the numbers from 1 to 10, probably you should keep them as 10 to 1, so that this shows the 10 matches before his last, and the last one will show his latest. So, this would be the nth last, this is what is the title I'll put, and the runs in that particular match by the selected player. So, I'll just bold this. Now, I have the necessary information to actually plot a line chart. So, what I'll do is, I'll select this data, I say insert a line chart, which will plot me something like this, and as I said earlier, all the columns which are with number based data, the system will try to plot them on the y-axis itself, and it gives some kind of auto numbering 1 to 10 on the x-axis. But that's not what we want. We don't want that nth last 10, 9, 8, 7 to be plotted on the y-axis. Instead, I want them to be plotted on the x-axis. So what I typically would like to do in that case is, I go right click on the chart, go to select data, the nth last I remove from the chart. So the blue line is missing because I don't want that as a plot of my chart. But at the same time, even I don't bother too much about the axis and all when I do a Sparkline chart. So I'll ignore whatever it has been written there. Now, as a part of the basic modification to this, I'll remove the title, the legend, even the axis I don't want. Yeah, but the vertical axis I don't want. But what I will simply try to do is, I will set the values fixed to see whether he is on the, whether he has scored on the upper side of the spectrum or on the lower side of the spectrum. I don't want this axis to be automatically updated with the data. So I'll change it like this. So to change the axis, I'll click on the axis and then press Control 1 to open up this axis options. By default, the minimum and the maximum value are auto. So I'll set them to fixed. Minimum I'll set to 0 and maximum, let's say I'll set it to 200. Right, I can even set it to a highest value. So we have, if there is any other highest, we can even modify it to that value. Fair enough. All right, then I'll say close. Then it's better for me to delete this axis, because now I can see whether this value is on the higher side of the spectrum or on the lower side. Even I can work out on the grid lines, which I don't need. I can remove these grid lines. I can make this chart as small as possible. I don't need anything else. I just need the values of this chart, nothing more than this. Right? And if required, expand the chart to occupy the entire space, because we want the chart to occupy as much space as possible, so that we can use the little space to bring more meaning into the chart. Right? Generally, this is plotted within one or two cells time, because that's what has to give more and more clarity. So what I'll do is, I'll do a cut of this, come to this dashboard sheet and do a pasting here. And I'll drag it into this location. Right, I'll make it try to fit in this location and probably try to fit it in this entire space. But yeah, trying to make the plot area as no fill. Right, even the chart area I'll select. I select the chart area also. Even the chart area I can make it no fill, and border also I can make it as no line. So now what I'm seeing is, I'm seeing that there is some kind of plot in this data. Now what I could very well go is, I select this entire space, put some kind of a border. And if required, I can even edit the color of this chart. Right? If I think that this color is not looking pretty much attractive, I can go to this line color. Instead of having automatic, I can select the color of my choice. Probably a blue or a green should solve the purpose. Right, so I'll go with the green. So this is what is the performance of the person in the last 10 innings. So since this entire width or the height will correspond to 200 runs, so if it is not that high, I can very well make out that he has not performed that extraordinarily in the last 10 innings. Whereas I look at some other person, we see that the values are more shifted towards the upper half in the last 10 innings, which means this guy has really performed well in the last 10 matches. So that's how we can very well make out the performance of each of the persons against the various countries or against in the various matches. The Sparkline charts are more and more useful from this standpoint. In a very small space, they can create a lot of meaning, but the main purpose of the usage of the Sparkline chart should be to test out a trend, whether something is an increasing or a decreasing trend, especially used for time-based data, look at the stock price performance or sales performance over a period, or such kind of stuff, the employee strength over a period. These kind of information can very well be depicted using the Sparkline chart. But yeah, to create this Sparkline chart, we have actually used nothing but a line chart itself in a very small area. And we have to create a data for plotting a better Sparkline chart, we have used an if function, and then we have used a large function, and we have used an index function to bring out the data. And using this, we have created one dynamic dashboard. Now you can try changing the data to any other player. You should be able to. Now you see for this person, this last innings is looking more or less flat, which means he did not perform well in any of the last 10 matches, and even the other data is not looking that attractive. Even the performance-wise, the average is not looking that attractive. So these kind of things can very well be interpreted using your different kinds of dynamic dashboard stuff. We'll try to create many more such kind of charts to make this dashboard more and more attractive. I hope this video has explained you clearly on the usage of the Sparkline chart and setting your data for the creation of enormous, excellent Sparkline charts. We will deal with a few more charts in our next videos. If you have any queries on this particular video, you can very well reach us on 9198480121223. You can even drop in an email at vamsidhar@paceguros.com. And you can visit our website www.paceguros.com for any training or consulting relating updates, or for any video related purchases in the areas of Excel, VBA, statistical analysis with SPSS or dashboards, or any other related trainings in the area of finance and analytics. Thanks a lot for listening to this video. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.